advice. The opinions and views of the hosts and guests do not reflect those of the station.
Good evening, Philippines. May gabi sa Tibuok, Mindanao, Visayas, ug sa Luzon. Ako po si Erik Espina at ito po ang inyong Republika. Alam niyo po, sa gabing ito ay ang ating inanyayahang panauhin ay isa sa mga haligi na sumulat at umukit sa kasaysayan ng ating bansa. Lalo sa mga panahon na nagkaroon ng kadiliman na tumakip sa ating bansa at sa buong kapuluan. Hindi na natin siya masyadong naririnig sa panahon na ito. Subalit, mahalaga po ang kanyang kwento na kailangang madinig ng bagong henerasyon, lalo ng ating mga kabataan. Ikinagagala ko pong ipakilala sa inyo ang tinaguriang Gabriela Silang ng dating Vice Presidente Salvador Doy Laurel. Walang iba kung hindi si former Senator Eva Estrada Kalaw. Good evening po.
Good evening.
Good evening. Ma'am, ang una nating tatalakayin ay itong Plaza Miranda. Okay. Kayo po ay kandidato noon ng Liberal Party sa Plaza Miranda.
Sa Miranda.
Oh. Yes.
As guest candidate of
guest
the
candidate
Liberal
kayo.
Party.
Yes.
Kasi ayaw akong isama ni Marcos na maging kandidato dun sa nationalista, although I was a nationalista.
Nationalista kayo noon?
Ayaw niya akong isama. Sabi ni Ninoy, halika dito. You'd be a guest candidate of the Liberal Party.
Bakit ayaw kayo isama dati ni Marcos?
Well, you know, I was supposing Marcos to some level.
Okay.
So, hindi ayaw na niya akong isama. But, Pinoy got me as guest candidate of the Liberal Party.
Okay.
So, I became my candidate still, galit na Marcos.
So, In that event, nandun kayo sa Plaza Miranda meeting de Avance?
Oh, of course.
So at that time po, meron din pala mga guest candidate nung panahon na yon?
Meron.
Okay, so hindi lang pala katulad ngayon na nakikita natin yung mga, may mga guest candidate ng mga coalition. So, you were there during the meeting de Avance?
Of the, during that bombing, yes.
Yes. Aha. Hindi ko alam ng mga publiko ito. Can you please walk us through, anong nakita ninyo? Anong naramdaman ninyo?
Nagkaroon ng bombing bigla.
Just very briefly po. Saan kayo nakaupo?
Nandun ako as guest candidate of
nandun
the Liberal
harap.
Party. Oo. Pagkatapos, nagkaroon ng... It was the opposition. Yung hindi tunay na opposition, yung mga sumasakay sa opposition.
Okay.
Ang talagang nag-mastermind ng kaguruhan na yun.
Okay.
So, ayan, nagkagulo nga.
Tinamaan po kayo?
In a way, yes. Pero not as badly as the others.
As sa Longa, hindi ganun. Sila Eddie Lardi, tinamaan din ng Granada, ano?
Oo.
Kayo po, ano kayo? Dumapa kayo? How was it?
Hindi ko matandaan, but definitely, we were in danger. Talagang not the opposition, the underground group.
The leftist?
Oo.
The CPP-NPA?
Oo.
Sa libro po ni Joby Salonga, at pati na rin sa libro na sinulat ninyo, yung My Journey ba yun yata, no? Ang tinuturo ninyong may kasalanan doon sa Plaza Miranda bombing ay yung Communist Party of the Philippines at si Joma Sison.
Totoo.
Yun po ang talagang may kinalaman doon.
Yun talagang ng gulo.
Okay.
They were the mastermind behind that group.
Okay. Sa palagay po ninyo, bakit naisip nila na parang ubusin ang Liberal Party at pati kayo ay nadamay kaya doon? Sa palagay po ninyo?
Ang tingin nila kaya, hindi ko alam, but definitely they were not, they were trying to destroy the growth of the democratic way, democratic processes. So they were putting all this glue without their, hindi sila halata na sila, ha?
Okay.
Ganyan. Patago sila, pero they were in a way using us without our knowledge.
Okay. They were trying to create a revolutionary situation?
Maybe. Maybe, I don't know. But definitely, they were trying to violate the
democratic space?
Opposition and...
NP, the NP-LP relationship?
Para nila yun.
Okay. And then para ang lumabas na ang may gawa nito ay yung administrasyon ni Marcos, parang ganun. Mm-hmm. Para yun ang ituro.
Oo, at ang akala namin nga si Marcos.
Si Marcos kaagad?
Oo. Kasi yun ang alam namin kagalit eh.
Oo.
Sila patagong kagalit eh.
Oo.
They're undergrounding everything.
Aha. When did... Ito pong revelation tungkol sa... na may kinalaman ng mga komunista this revelation na walang kinalaman pala ang Nationalista Party o sila Marcos, this came to you only later on, no?
Well, we realized it later.
Later on.
Mm-hmm.
But at that time, it was
akala
really...
Akala namin, ang kalaban namin lang yun. Yung pala silang underground.
Aha. So, na-hospital ho ba kayo?
Oh.
Na-hospital talaga kayo, no?
But not badly. There are more who were badly hurt.
Aha. And, I remember si Senator Salonga parang nasa bingit po ng kamatayan, ano? They were walking in and out at death's death's bed, no?
Siyang kwan, siyang heavily harp.
And then ano ho naging resulta doon? I think dalawa lang yata sa NP ang naging ang nanalo doon, ano? Karamihan sa inyo yata eh, I think it was 6-2
more the opposition.
6 from the no? 6 ano?
More from the opposition one.
Okay. Kayo po, lumipat na kayo ng Liberal Party at that
hindi,
at that
I was just guest candidate.
So you maintained your...
Oh, inimbita ako ni Noy because he knew that aalisin ako ni Marcos.
Okay.
Sa Nationalista group.
Okay.
Hindi ako sinali doon. So ang ginawa ni Noy, inimbita akong as guest candidate of the Liberal Party.
Okay. Before you ran for senator po, ano po yung posisyon ninyo noon?
Before I ran as senator, I was an ordinary citizen.
Ah, talaga ho, ah?
Mm-mm.
Ano ho kayo? Housewife? Businesswoman?
Well, I was a teacher.
Teacher ho kayo, ah?
Mm-hmm.
Saan ho kayo nagtuturo nun?
Well, National Teachers, Far Eastern, Centro Escolar.
Aha.
I was teaching. I was really a teacher.
Aha.
And suddenly, they needed a woman candidate. I was interested in politics.
Aha.
Okay. I went in.
Paano ko kayo nagkakilala ni Ninoy Aquino noon?
He's my cousin.
Ah, pinsan niyo po siya?
Oo.
Okay, this is something that the public does not know, no? Paano ko kayo naging magpinsan po?
The father of Ninoy and my father are cousins, but they became stepbrothers.
Ganun ho ba?
Eventually, when the father died, my grandmother took them. And so they grew up like brothers.
Aha.
We're very close.
Uh-huh.
It's a very close family. The three grandmothers, the three sisters,
okay,
had one was mine,
okay,
one was Ninoy's,
okay,
and one was another cousin of ours.
You knew Senator Ninoy Aquino, the late Senator Ninoy Aquino, way back during your younger days? Parang ganun, no?
Oh, yes. Kapantay ko siya, kaedad ko siya, more or less.
Parang kababata nyo?
Mm-mm. But I'm older, a little.
Aha.
Ang tawag niya sa akin, Ache. So
okay.
I'm older. Ache in Kapampangan is ate.
Okay. Mm. Okay, so paano ho kayo, during your younger days, pupunta kayo sa bahay nila, tapos siya po pupunta sa bahay ninyo? How was the family relationship?
Our house in Lepanto is near the Senate.
Okay.
And he was senator.
Okay.
And whenever he wants to take a shower, he would go home and take a shower at home.
Uh-huh.
Well, he's really one member. He's our family.
Uh-huh. And then, paano ho na nabuksan yung pagkakataon na sabi niya, gusto mo bang tumakbong senador? Did he made that offer to you?
I can't remember.
Okay.
He didn't ask me. I ran as senator.
Okay. Okay. And then he decided na dito ka na lang sa Liberal Party.
When the Nationalista didn't want to carry me.
Okay. And then you took your oath as Nationalista Party or was it Liberal Party later?
I am Nationalista but I was guest candidate of the Liberal Party.
And then when you entered as senator, how was that? What was your party affiliation? NP pa rin?
Mm-mm.
Okay. At that time po si...
MP but guest candidate of the Liberal Party.
Party. Okay. During your time po, sino po ang Senate President po ninyo sa ano? So, was that, ano, Hilpuyat pa ba ho yung ano nyo, ang Senate President ninyo?
Sa tingin po.
Hilpuyat pa rin. Okay. And then, malipat lang tayo, titignan po natin yung mga significant events po sa buhay ninyo at sa nangyari sa ating bansa dahil nababago po minsan yung kwento ng ating bansa. Ano? Kasi minsan, depende kung sino yung tagapatnugot o sino yung nagsusulat, eh nababago ho yung ano no yung pagsasalaysay. Pagdating po sa 1081, how did this come about? Did you have an inkling that Marcos was going to eventually declare martial law?
Anong 1081?
Martial law po, 1081.
Oh. Why he declared martial law?
Uh-huh.
Well, we were not surprised.
You knew that. That was did you have that inkling?
If it came, we were not surprised. It's not something na bakit but niya ginawa yan.
Okay.
No, we were not surprised
because of
hindi, Marcos is unpredictable eh.
Okay.
It's quite unpredictable.
Was it because the conditions warranted it?
I don't know, but I think it was more to his advantage that he would declare it. Mm-hmm. Of course.
How would you characterize the conditions then after the Plaza Miranda bombing? And then the series of demonstrations in Malacañang.
With all that, the two-party system was still strong.
Okay.
Hindi ngayon sabog ang mga partido.
Magulo.
Sabog. Okay. You don't know anymore what really they stand for, who is with whom. Magulo mo konti.
In short, halo-halo.
Hindi clear.
It is like
the stands are not clear. They're just there. I don't know why they're there.
Because they're known.
Or walang ibang papartnan, they join.
Aha. So parang halo-halo na pinagsamang fiesta. parang ganun ho, no? It was unlike before.
Very clear.
Aha.
Very clear what you stand for. Or you're nowhere.
Aha.
If you don't stand for anything, you're nowhere. Hindi ba sa kasali ka?
Okay.
Magulo ngayon.
During 1081 po, when martial law was declared, what did Eva Estrada Kalaw do?
Nung nag-martial law?
Martial law po.
Ano bang nangyari noon?
Did you stay home?
No.
Did you attempt to go to the Senate?
No.
Did you meet with the Liberal Party?
No, I became an underground with the group of sino nga itong group?
Hindi pa kayo sumali kay Laurel noon? Kasi that was about mga 1980s ho yan eh.
But definitely, I was Nationalista.
Okay.
As guest candidate of the Liberal Party.
There was a time po, yung 1978 laban. Nung tumakbo po si Ninoy sa 1978 laban, what were you busy with? Nung tumakbo si Ninoy noon, the first election, yung nagkaroon ng noise barrage dito sa buong Metro Manila.
Si Ninoy nung maging kandidato?
Yes, sa 1978 laban. What was Senator Kalaw doing?
I was for the Ninoy, definitely. I could had no choice.
Uh-huh.
And then Ninoy deserved to be there.
Uh-huh.
He could contribute a lot.
Uh-huh. And then in the 1980s, that was the time na sumama na po kayo kay Laurel.
1980 ba yun?
81, 82, 83.
Mm-hmm.
To put up the Unido po, no?
Mm-hmm.
And then you headed the ano ba yun? Now yung Organization of Women's parang ganun, tama ho ba yun?
National Organization
for Women.
Oh, amen.
How did it come about po na nagkaanuhan kayo ni Senator Laurel at that time? Nagkasama po at parang nag-gel together ang mga ideas ninyo at parang
Nationalista talaga ako eh.
Okay.
And so, it was easy to get along with the Laurel group because they're talagang nationalists yan.
Pinatawag ko kayo? Or did you call for a
meeting? Automatically, we got together because we believed in the same thing. Nationalista pareho eh.
Okay.
Walang conflict.
Who called for the meeting po? Was it Speaker Laurel? Was it a meeting of different individuals, different senators?
I can't remember.
Ano hong napagkayarian ninyo to put up sort of like an umbrella organization? Parang UNIDO, ganun.
Pagkayarian?
Did you decide to put up an umbrella organization to compete with the KBL?
Automatic yun eh.
Yung UNIDO?
Oo, you have to, it will be the result of... if you didn't have to form it, automatic it would happen.
Ang sino po more or less yung mga nag-comprise ng UNIDO? Kayo, Laurel? Who were the members of UNIDO? Kayo, Laurel?
Laurel, mostly nationalistas.
Okay. Sila Adasa was there. Sila Kumobono Adasa was there.
Yeah.
And then, I think I remember po, Bicol Saro. Was Bicol Saro part of the group?
Sino?
Bicol Saro. I think Bicol Saro...
Sino nang head yan?
Hindi ko na rin matandaan. Pati si...
Hindi, taga Sursogon.
Yes, taga Sursogon. And then meron din po yata sa Bulacan. Meron din yata tayo sa... Si Ruding Mercado ko ba? Parang ganun ho. Yan yung mga... Basta different groups from all over the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
Put up the UNIDO. At ano hong purpose ng UNIDO noon? In order to... Ano ito? Alternative po?
UNIDO was to more or less unite the opposition.
Okay.
Kaya UNIDO eh.
Okay.
And because sumasabog na din yung opposition eh. So, just more or less to unite it. To have a stronger opposition.
What role did the Communist Party have in the...
Pataguyan.
In the spectrum of the martial law? Did the communists try to...
Pataguyan.
Wala bang, hindi ba sila lumapit kay Laurel at makipag-usap na baka pwede tayo magsama at join effort?
Hindi ko alam, pero hindi patago yung gawa nila.
Okay.
Patago yung mga leftists.
Uh-huh.
Sumisingit lang sila. They were using us in a way, pero patago.
Ginagamit nila pati ang UNIDO ginagamit nila?
They were using us. Madikot yung mga yan.
But did the Laurels ever think of accepting them or talagang inilayo sila?
Hindi inilayo, but I don't think Laurel ever thought of
bringing them in.
Even accept, no, nor we, nor us.
I remember during some of the speeches of Laurel, lalo na yung doon sa Pampanga, he would characterize what was happening before doon sa panahon ng martial law. Na parang dalawang bato ang nagbabanggaan. Yung puwersa ng diktadura daw at puwersa ng mga komunista na parehong armado.
He said that.
Yes, tapos yung UNIDO was the one that would provide the democratic alternative.
Yeah.
Correct. So that was the purpose of UNIDO. Tatandaan ko po kayo nung nagsasalita kayo, you were very anti-communist pa.
Ah, syempre. How can you like communism?
And then, dun po sa, tatanda ko, nag-iikot-ikot po kayo sa Pilipinas.
Oo, lahat.
What areas do you remember na nag-ikot-ikot po kayo?
Lahat. Mindanao, everywhere. I was...
What was the message of Eva Estrada Kalaw to, the different parts of the Philippines during that time?
Particular message?
Especially it was since the country under martial law.
Oh, but it was more of a campaign eh. Mm-hmm. Nagkakampanya kami noon eh. Mm-hmm. So naturally, we would bring out the points of the Nationalista Party at that time. Mm-hmm. They bringing them to us. Ang kalaban namin ang liberal, but this was political, open political labanan. Ang nag-underground dyan yung group yun.
Yung mga communists. This was the time of martial law po, and then yung KBL talagang, the KBL was really very strong during these times.
Because of Marcos.
How did you handle the campaign? You
openly.
Are in front of the KBL, kahit martial law.
Openly.
Hindi kayo natatakot nun?
bakit ka matatakot? You're fighting for a cause. You have to stand. Take a stand before the public.
And then, you would stand in front of a stage? Hmm. Or mga trucks?
Talk against these people who are undermining democracy. Talagang straight talk. Maaaring bariling ka doon if they like, if they don't like what you're saying.
Pero at any moment, was there ever a time that you wavered or that you were worried for your life?
I never was worried for my life. If I were worried, I would not go into it.
Pero palagi kayong sinasama ni then Vice President or Senator Vice President Laurel sa mga sorties?
Oo, we were together.
Bakit po kayo tinawag na Gabriela silang ni ano?
Sino tumawag?
Si Senator Doy Laurel. Tinawag niya kayong ang Gabriela silang ng UNIDO. Bakit po ganun ang nangyari?
Siguro dahil sa that time, matapang si Gabriela silang.
At matapang ako kayo?
Ngayon ang nagtatapang-tapangan na, hindi ako si Gabriela silang naman of that time.
How was the reception of the people when you were going out and talking about martial law?
Very good reaction. Malaking crowd. When we come, talagang malaki. They want to hear. They want to listen. You have to clarify to the people. Some of them just talk. Our purpose is to clarify to the people because people don't want to tend to know.
Okay.
Some of them just talk for the, maybe to impress people, I don't know what's their purpose. Pero kami, we came to explain kung anong nangyayari, kung saan sila napapanig. There was a purpose in our appearance, hindi naman basta we want to talk because we want to be voted upon or we want to be popular or whatever is the reason. No, we had a message. But what for if you don't have any message? Why talk at all?
And people wanted to know what was happening to the country.
That's the only way they get to know. They don't really get to the newspapers.
Especially saka, the ordinary Filipinos.
Hindi, at saka talagang attentive sila naman, ha? They're not stupid, they're listening. It's good to talk to the people directly.
At yung mga tao po, kahit may martial law at that time, hindi takot, ano? Parang, pag nandiyan kayo, nakikita nila kayo, nakikita nila si Laurel at yung mga opposition, parang handa silang lumapit din dahil they would like to listen to what you would have to say.
When there's a public meeting, you can be sure na it's a popular thing. People really come. We go, you know, we come from Manila yet to talk to them. Makita mo, the crowd is large. And that was the only the communication. Newspapers don't exist more or less in the far areas, nor do they read it. So the only communication is when us leaders go there and they listen. So it's direct talking.
Okay.
Which we should.
It's a direct conversation with the people.
Oh. That was necessary. We had to go. The more we cover, the better for the country.
At that time, the opposition was spending money for itself, no? Kasi walang pera, eh. Wala kayong pera, no?
Wala.
Hindi ka tulad ng KBL noon or ng gobyerno, no?
Oh, ang BG Marcos, wala.
So how did you were contributing money among yourselves? How was that?
Whatever expenses, sige, tulungan.
Tulungan?
Some of them have no money to give, never mind. Those who have, they give, ganun.
So parang KKB? Kanya-kanyang tulungan, kanya-kanyang bayan?
Just get going so we can achieve what we want. Wala nang, bakit ang contribution mo kulang? Hindi pwede. Wala yun.
Okay. Republika will return. And when we come back, we're going to try to find out the perspective of Senator Kalaw here, especially when during the arrival of Senator Ninoy and what happened in the airport. We're also going to ask Senator Kalaw here because I understand she was very, very crucial and very, very important in the entry of President Erik Estrada into politics, especially into national office, when Republika returns.